Welcome, Dreamers. Happy Friday, everybody. Hope everyone's looking forward to the weekend. Last video, we did a tower build in the desert. Today, I want to build another tower, but this time, it's going to be a tower of terraforming. This build will be a two-part video. The first part will be released today, the second part tomorrow. Now, we won't be totally terraforming. We'll only be doing part terraforming and part building with actual materials, but the goal here is to make two ways to traverse this tower, via the terraformed route and via the built route. Before we get into building though, a quick reminder that DreamWorld is available in early access. If you head down to the description, you'll find a link to DreamWorld's website where you can get information about getting our free trial so you can try DreamWorld out for yourself. And if you like what you play and like what you see in today's video, feel free to purchase the game. But now to the build. Today, we're going to be building the actual structural part of this tower. So terraforming will take place in tomorrow's video, and today we'll be building the actual framework of the tower. So here we go. Let's build the Tower of Terraforming in DreamWorld. Before we actually start the build, let's briefly describe how we want to go about this. So, the actual interior structure is going to be a regular wooden tower. We're going to use conifer wood to construct that part. We're going to use lots of windows and lots of door frames. You want to leave openings in this tower so we can walk out onto a terraformed path. Once we finish the tower today, the goal in part two is going to be to build a terraformed path that wraps around the exterior of the tower and creates an alternative way to get from the bottom to the top of the tower. So you can traverse the terraformed path going from the bottom to the top, or you can even do some farming, you know, up and down the tower. This will allow us to create different farming sections along different points of the build. The magic of terraforming, you gotta love it. As far as the positioning of the tower and where we want to till an area, we want to make sure that we pick an area in the forest where there's grass. Originally, I picked out a space that had sand, which was really flat and I barely had to till. But then I realized that in order to make the terraformed path, I would have to use sand instead of the thousands of grass I had. So if we pick an area in the grass where we can use grass to build up, you know, and terraform upwards, we won't have to do any farming because I already have, you know, 1,500 to 2,000 grass that I have saved up in my boxes. We're gonna till out a medium-sized plot here. The tower itself isn't gonna be super big. It's gonna be a 3x3 design. However, we wanna leave a little bit of room to actually, you know, make way for terraforming. I want to have a lot of space to breathe here so we can have enough room to make the terraformed path wrapping around the actual tower. It's going to look like a little tendril has formed into the ground and just wrapped itself around our build. But this is our plot of land that we have that we can build off of so far. Now that we have it, let's get right to creating the foundations. Again, we're going to do a 3x3 foundations, all conifer wood. We might add some more decorative pieces to the build in part two, but today I just want to get the framework of the tower down because as we build the path upwards, we're going to have to make changes to the tower to accommodate, you know, how the path wraps around the build. For the walls, you're going to notice I put two window frames next to the door, and the rest of the first floor is going to be just walled off. However, the rest of the build, I'm going to use all window frames. I want to get as much light seeping through the build as possible. I want you to be able to look outside of the walls as you're climbing the tower and see the terraformed path, you know, as you go up. As you move up the tower, I'm gonna have different levels of the tower that'll allow you to walk outside and have, you know, door frames that'll have access outside to the terraformed path. Every third story of walls, we're gonna create one of these platforms where you can actually have outside access. You'll notice here at first that I'm actually gonna put four door frames on each level where there's a path, but we're gonna have to change that later. I'll explain why. For our staircases, we're gonna use the ramp stairs and mix them with actual floor pieces. We're not gonna do a lot of interior decorating with this tower, so I can afford to use most of the interior space dedicating towards the staircase. We could have used spiral stairs or L-shaped stairs, but making the stairs this way gives us plenty of room to walk up and down. As I'm putting down the floor on the first landing area, you'll notice that some of the door frames don't actually have flooring connected to it because of where the staircase is. This led me to remove most of the other door frames. I ended up only really leaving like one behind on each one of these platform areas. I'm also gonna remove this door frame because that's where we're gonna start the next section of stairs. We can't put a staircase right in front of a door frame. That just doesn't really make structural sense. Unfortunately though, this leaves us with only one door frame per landing level. So only one entrance and exit point on this floor. You'll notice that each one of these landing levels where I put some flooring down and have access points to the outside, they're all basically symmetrical. They all have the same design. However, their door frame access to the outside might be in a different spot. I didn't necessarily intend for the build to be like very symmetrical and all the floors to be designed the same, but it worked for the way that I designed the stairs. Making the tower designed this way though is hopefully gonna make it easier to build my terraformed path from the bottom all the way to the top of the build. As we keep building up from this level of terrace, I'm gonna just keep using window frames to keep, you know, a way to see in and outside of the base. You really wanna see that path, you know, going up as you go up. And again, we're only gonna fit one access point on each one of these terraces. I'm probably just going to do three of these terrace levels, and then when we get to the very top of the build, I'm going to design it a little bit differently. We'll break the mold from having each terrace designed the same. We'll have, you know, a different shape of the tower at the very top, and we'll do, you know, maybe some outside walkways. Now that we're on the final layer of the terraces, we're going to actually plan to make a walkway on the outside of this level. We're putting the walkway here because this is where the actual pathway is going to end on the tower. The terraform pathway will most likely adapt into this walkway, and then from here on up, the tower is going to be just the interior framing build. Like we did with our last build, on this build for the area above this part of the tower, we're gonna try to convert the tower to a cylindrical shape as opposed to the square shape we have now. I'm also gonna make sure to put a banister on the outside walkway so that it's not as easy to fall off while you're running around up here. You definitely don't wanna take fall damage and end up dying and having to come all the way back. To access the top part of the tower, we're gonna put a spiral staircase. To make the upper part of the build the way I wanna make it, I'm not gonna have enough room to do the style of staircase I was doing before. For the platform up here, we're gonna stick with square foundation pieces, and then on top of those square foundation pieces is where we're going to actually build the cylindrical tower, the start of the cylindrical tower. Using cylindrical walls here, we're going to actually start the shape of the round part of the tower. I'm going to place the walls in a way that I know I'll have good access from the spiral staircase that leads up here. I also don't want to block off where the spiral staircase meets this level of the tower. I'll now wall off the entirety of this level, which will make the transition from the square part of the build to the cylindrical part of the build look a little bit more seamless. Plus, I want this area where you transition from the shape of the build to be enclosed. Before we start building up, let's also put some fencing down where the staircase is so you don't end up falling down the stairs. From here on up, we're gonna use cylindrical windows to build the walls of the round tower. Just like we did with the bottom section of the tower, I want as much sight into and out of the tower as I can get. When you get this high up in a build, the views are really good, so I want players to be able to see them. At the top of the staircase, let's put a little platform area so you can actually stand at the top of this tower once you get to it. We're also going to make a walkway on the outside of this tower as well. Before we start the walkway though, let's wall in this section of the tower. I want a little entry room that, you know, will keep you enclosed before you walk out onto the walkway. Now we just have to create the walkway. We're going to use the same walkway design as we did with our previous build, the Desert Stone Tower. Now all there is to do is to put fencing around the walkway so we don't fall off and take fall damage. And lastly, let's throw a roof on top of the tower. Alright, that concludes the tower build for today. Terraform Tower has its interior completely done. Aside from, you know, a few decorative changes on the interior of the build, we now have a shape that we can terraform around in part 2. Thank you all so much for watching this Friday's video, though. Reminder, if you like what you see in today's video, head down to the description where there's a link to DreamWorld's website. You'll be able to get our free trial or purchase the game there. Subscribe to the channel if you want to see videos just like this one. And have an amazing Friday, everybody. Looking forward to the weekend. See you all tomorrow. Bye-bye.